Hello guys, in this video we are going to talk about major periods of English and American literature both, and this will be an overview. We will be talking about some important writers and some important characteristics of the ages, both English and American literature, their dates and important writers and their works.
Hello friends, you are most welcome on my YouTube channel, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Click on subscribe here. दोस्तों, अगर आप मेरे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करते हैं तो आपको आने वाली वीडियोस का लिंक आसानी से मिलता रहेगा। आशा करता हूं कि चैनल आपकी तैयारी में हेल्पफुल होगा। गुड लक फ्रेंड्स, नाउ एंजॉय द वीडियो।
सो आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू प्लीज टू लाइक द वीडियो एंड कमेंट बिलो वेदर यू लाइक द वीडियो और नॉट, एंड इफ यू वांट टू सजेस्ट सम मैटर यू वुड लाइक मी टू मेक वीडियोस ऑन, यू कैन राइट डाउन इन कमेंट बॉक्स। Let's go ahead. First of all, there is a question that what is period? Why do we call a particular period of with that particular name, like Romanticism? Why do we call that period Romanticism? So a period is a dominant mode, style, or type of literature within a specific historical context. A period is usually indicative of the controlling philosophical perspective of the time. As such, periods are not generally confined to the literature of time. Rather, their characteristics can be seen in other art forms as well as non-literary texts, and dates are approximation. Ye bahut important hai. Date of approximation means they take a period between approximate dates, right? So it's approximation. So sometimes, like Romanticism is considered to start with songs of experience and songs of innocence by William Blake. And some say it started with 1798, but this is well accepted. Old English period is considered between 450 to 1066, and few surviving texts with a little in common we have. If we talk about literature, अगर हम literature की बात करें उस time के बारे में, तो हमारे पास बहुत कम texts उस time के हैं, and language closer to modern German than modern English. And here we have language closer to modern German. Us time ki jo language thi, that was modern German, then modern English. Frequently reflect non-English influence, and Beowulf, The Wanderer, these are important works of that time. We will be taking one or two examples. Next is Middle English. It is from 1066 to 1500. Works frequently offer religiously didactic content. Okay, didactic means having some lessons for life. So religiously didactic content you will find in this time, and written for performance at court or for festivals. Geoffrey Chaucer's The Canterbury Tales, The Cuckoo Song, and Mystery Plays, you will find the important work. These important works in this period in Middle English. Next one is English Renaissance. Renaissance means the rebirth. Okay. From 1500 to 1660, and here we see lots of influence of Aristotle, Ovid, and other Greco-Roman thinkers, as well as science and exploration in this age from 1660. Primarily the text for public performance, like plays, marks, and some books of poetry. William Shakespeare, Christopher Marlowe, Ben Jonson, Francis Bacon, Fletcher, Francis Beaumont, you will find the works of these writers in this period. Neoclassical period, Enlightenment and Age of Reason, or this is also called Age of Prose. Reaction to the expansiveness of the Renaissance in the direction of order and restraint, you can say, and developed in France, Molière, Rousseau, Voltaire, these are thinkers who influenced the writings of English literature at that time. Emphasized classical ideas of rationality and control. Human nature is constant through time. This is very important. Let's read this again. Emphasized classical ideas of rationality and control. Okay, is of reason is this. So human nature is constant through time. They say what people think in old English time, the same thing is happening in neoclassical period. Art should reflect the universal commonality of human nature. All men are created equal. Reasoning is emphasized as the highest faculty. You can see reason is emphasized as the highest faculty. You can note down. Neoclassical period, it's again same. Writing should be well structured. Emotion should be controlled and emphasize qualities like wit. So you can see here that they are ignoring emotions. And so if there is a question, who valued emotions most? So those were romantics, you know. So again, if we talk about rules, we talk about 18th century. If we talk about emotions, we talk about romanticism. Here we if we talk about the different, this is very important. In England, we had John Locke, John Milton. The biggest epic was written in that period. Paradise Lost, Alexander Pope, Essay on Man, Jonathan Swift, Gulliver Travels, Henry Fielding, Tom Jones. And if you want to know about Tom Jones more, or Paradise more, Gulliver's Travel, you can find out. Or even Robinson Crusoe by Daniel Defoe, Jane Austen's Sense and Sensibility, Emma, Pride and Prejudice. I have some videos on Paradise Lost, and Gulliver's Travels and Tom Jones. You can search on my videos. You will find there. American Benjamin Franklin, Poor Richard's Almack. I have made also a separate video on American literature, so you can watch that video. You can make your own notes. Kyunki notes banane bahut zaruri hote hain. If you are not making your notes by your own and you are relying on another's notes and another's videos, like I don't say only watching videos will make you successful in your studies. I want you to make your own notes. Just take matter from different videos and create your own notes. That is key to success. Thomas Jefferson, the Declaration of Independence, and James Madison, the Constitution of the United States. Now we have Romantic period. This is my, I like this most. England between 1785 to 1830, and in America, so see the difference. In England, it was 1785 to 1830, and I have already told you 1798 is the date if there is a question or paper. America 1800 to 1860, reaction against the scientific rationality of neoclassicism. And why we call it neoclassicism, you can search the video on my playlist, and definitely you'll get a video for neoclassicism. Actually, in short, actually the writer followed classic writers. That's why it is called neoclassicism. They were rule bumped. They were following a lot of rules. That's why it is called neoclassicism. But it was reaction against, when we talk about, I just told you they valued emotions. Okay, so reactions and industrial revolution developed in Germany, Kant and Goethe. So romantic period, it was developed in Germany and emphasized individuality, intuition, imagination, idealism, nature as opposed to society and social order, elevation of the common man, folklore, myth, mystery, and the supernatural things were there. You see, Ancient Mariner by S.T. Coleridge. If you want to see the example of mystery and supernaturalism, you can read that chapter or that poem. Next is the same. It is continued. England, if we talk about England, it was Robert Burns, To the Mouse, the important works, William Blake, Songs of Innocence, Songs of Experience, William Wordsworth, Lyrical Ballad, Strindberg Abbey, Intimation of Immortality, I Wandered Lonely as a Cloud, Samuel Tyler Coleridge, The Rime of Ancient Mariner, Kublai Khan, it's a K-H-A-N, sorry. Lord Byron, Don Juan, Percy Bysshe Shelley, Ozymandias, Mary Wollstonecraft Shelley, Frankenstein. I have just made a summary on Frankenstein, so please just watch that one and write down in comment box whether you like or not. I will be pinning the in comment box also all the summaries I have made. I have made near about 30 summaries, so you can check out them. John Keats, Ode on a Grecian Urn, Sir Walter Scott, Ivanhoe. I'm going to make a summary on Ivanhoe now. In America, if we talk about romantic period in America, Washington Irving, Rip Van Winkle, The Legend of Sleepy Hollow, Edgar Allan Poe, The Raven, Tales of Grotesque and Arabesque, The Murders in Rue Morgue, The Philosophy of Composition, James Fenimore Cooper, The Last of the Mohicans, Herman Melville, Moby Dick, Billy Bird, National Hawthorne, Twice Told Tales, The Scarlet Letter, William Cullen Bryant, The Waterfowl, Oliver Wendell Holmes, The Sambord Nautilus, Henry Wordsworth Longfellow, Paul Revere Wright, and James Russell Lowell, The First Snowfall. These are American and these are England, in England. So you can compare their works, what were the similarities and dissimilarities there. So next one is romantic period again, American. Here, so here is a very important term, transcendentalism. You can check out a video in my playlist, romantic philosophy. So American transcendentalism is equal to romantic philosophy. And what is romantic philosophy? I have already told you just two seconds away, ago. So you can check out. Named for, you can just, you know, go back. You can listen to the romantic philosophy that is similar to American transcendentalism. Named for the core beliefs that are spiritual nature. Okay. So do you find spirituality in Wordsworth? Transcends rationality and religious doctrines, thus it is found in intuition. So intuition, romantic philosophy, developed by New England, influenced by Eastern philosophy, prosophers and abolitionist, Ralph Waldo Emerson, the American scholar, Henry David Thoreau, Walden, civil disobedience, Walt Whitman, Leaves of Grass. Victorian period, named for the reign of Queen Victoria, Britain's longest reigning monarch. So this is a fact for you. Period of stability and prosperity for Britain. British society, extremely class conscious. Literature seen as a bridge between romanticism and modernism. And so Victorian, it could be a question for us that which literature is seen as the bridge between romanticism and modernism. So it was Victorian literature. Generally emphasized realistic portrayals of common people, sometimes to promote social change. Some writers continue to explore Gothic themes begin in romantic period. In the romantic period, we have some important writers: Charles Dickens, David Copperfield, Oliver Twist, Great Expectations, George Eliot, Middlemarch, Thomas Hardy, Tessa of D'Urbervilles, Robert Louis Stevenson, The Strange Case of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, Rudyard Kipling, Jungle Book, Lewis Carroll, Alice's Adventure in Wonderland, Charlotte Bronte, Jane Eyre, Emily Bronte, Wuthering Heights, Alfred Lord Tennyson, In Memoriam, Elizabeth Barrett Browning, Sonnet from the Portuguese, Robert Browning, My Last Duchess, Matthew Arnold, Dover Beach, Oscar Wilde, The Importance of Being Honest. Realistic period in America. Reaction against romantic values developed in France and emphasized the commonplace and ordinary as opposed to the romanticized individual, sought to depict life as it was not idealized. Mark Twain, The Adventure of Huckleberry Finn, Ambrose Bierce, The Occurrence of Owl Creek Bridge, William Dane Howells, A Modern Instance, and Theodore Dreiser's Sister Karen. These are important works of this period. Realistic period, there is new naturalism, and it is also called hyperrealism, named for the belief that man is simply a higher order animal, and thus under the same natural constraints and limitations as other animals, controlled by heredity and environment. Stephen Crane, Maggie, A Girl of the Street, The Red Badge of Courage, Jack London, To Build a Fire, Upton Sinclair, The Jungle. Edwardian period, name of King Edward, named for King Edward. Some see as a continuation of Victorian period, however, the status quo is increasingly threatened. Distinction between literature and popular fictions. You can be as Joseph Conrad, E.M. Forrester, and George Bernard Shaw, and A.C. Bradley. So friends, we have covered most of the periods now. I hope you liked this video. And please do comment, share, and like the video. Bye-bye. Take care. See you in next video.